between the leaders could be a huge advantage.
There you go, Dean Carter coming away there. So straight under the front straight. What was that? No, it's a truck. Marty was in here as well. Don't know where he's disappeared. There he is. Been followed up by the truck.
Down the finish line to come. Going a lot slower than he was.
Guys, now would be absolutely all right. Looks like a little bit of hail now, which doesn't help. Now, Marty's club coming in, coming about his dick.
Good, Harold.
As the rain takes a slight breath and eases up, we can see down the railway line there. The lights are flashing, the sirens are on.
No,
that's Andy Murdoch.
That's Andy Murdoch,
yeah.
Yeah, there was a couple of cars in between. Jason Richards was one of those in between Talbot and Aaron.
Yeah, Jason was. Talbot was behind Havy on the starting grid just before. Head out. Around the last corner. So two laps remaining. See one down the railway line now. That could be Talbot.
Man, a rooster tail. What do you say there, Mark? You want sunshine? You say, Mark, you want a bit more sunshine?
Okay, so it pops over the ARB hill and it's Talbot Cox. Andy Murdoch skating to the finish line.
So these guys are finding it hard.
It's actually been slowly getting up in his times.
He's improved it well every time he's gone out today, which is fantastic. The world team that's in here as well.
Yes. Just sees Talbot just skating all the way to that finish line. See these cars just struggling. They're trying to get traction there. So Havy's opened up the lead to a fair bit now. He's got 2:39 of breathing space.
Yeah, but anything can happen in those 2 minutes too. So we're waiting on our third place car.
Apparently that one is Andy Murdoch, but we're waiting for Greg Garland to get around. This was the battle between Andy and Greg.
Only 2 minutes slower. Yeah. Truck.
Yes, Greg. Hey, Greg, I just moved over to the ARB jump.
They welding through. Say that we see Greg Garland just trying to get some traction in that mud. Yeah, just spinning the wheels. There's a Malloy entry.
Probably been done. So you can see on the screen, oh look at that. That's coming back in along the railway line. That's coming to the central excavation crossover. Wow.
So here comes Greg to complete his lap. See all the other buggies coming through here aquaplaning before. Out of this big truck just sneaking sideways and very tail happy. Just makes up, I need to make sure that it's like a movie. Now the rain currently leading Aaron Habey, car 57. Talbot Cox in second position, car number 16. In third position, car number 410, Greg Garner. Not far behind, car 66, Andy Murdoch.
So Greg's still holding that third spot.
Yep. The one person that has leapfrogged a couple of spots is Daniel Wells. He's got himself up into sixth position. He was previously in eighth position, I think it was. Last one. We're just waiting for some of these other cars to come through now. Make sure that is fresh time.
Just to find Gary Turnbull is also in here as part of this.
Yeah, we'll be waiting for time for Gary Turnbull, who'll be one that might upset the apple cart a little bit. Obviously, after that round of laps, Lana Horan is slowly starting to progress down. See, Toddy Wheeler's car 85. See some of these guys struggling even coming to the finish line.
There's the Dean McGinley entry, 7-8-7-6-4. If you can.
Yeah, you want to keep moving along.
Let's find out how much force that he's got. time how the rods were entering. Now the sun decides to come out behind us. This is day on mark. So we look on the screen and the vision